Welcome to Holman United Methodist Church, located in Los Angeles, California. We are a church that believes in the Word of God as it is manifested in Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. We believe in the Holy Bible, and we trust that there is a word of hope, instruction, and healing for us all. Thanks for joining us today, and let's journey together as we follow God.
Welcome to the Holman United Methodist Church, the Church of the Bells. We are located at 3320 West Adams Boulevard in the historic West Adams District of Los Angeles. The Reverend Dr. Ken Walden serves as our senior pastor. In compliance with guidelines and instructions from our local and state governments, as well as our denomination, we are not holding a worship service with the congregation on site in the sanctuary until we are authorized to do so. We are presenting this broadcast in compliance with those regulations, maintaining social distancing and utilizing personal protective equipment so our congregation and community at large can listen in on the radio and through the internet. Good morning. It's the fifth Sunday in Lent here at the Church of the Bells, March 21, 2021. We encourage you to visit and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Type youtube.com/Holman Church in your internet browser, or you can go to YouTube directly and type Holman Church in the search box. There, you will see worship services and other engaging content. We ask you to click the thumbs up button, subscribe, and then click the bell icon to receive notifications. And again, please subscribe. During these unprecedented times, we encourage you to stay safe, but also remember that churches around the world, as well as Holman, are still in need of your financial support and prayers. So we offer them for you and hope that you have a safe and blessed week. This ministry broadcast live on KJLH FM 102.3 reaches a broad audience across the greater Los Angeles area. We are grateful for this opportunity to be in ministry with the greater community through the generosity of our radio broadcast sponsors. We look forward to your support through your radio broadcast sponsorship to honor a loved one, celebrate a special occasion, or promote your business or event. Call Holman Church at 323-703-5868 for more information. You can also contribute online to our ministry or other activities at holmanchurch.com. Let us partner with you in sharing your news. Thank you for listening, and we now join the church service currently in progress.
to the Holman United Methodist Church worship experience, for we believe that God is still moving, even now. We have an exciting worship service for you planned out. We have wonderful music, wonderful prayers, liturgical dancing, because we believe that God is worthy to be praised. We are people who are called to worship.
Please join me in our call to worship. This is the fifth step on our Lenten journey, the step of sacrifice.
Be with us, Lord, as we take this step.
This requires the willingness to give all of our life to the Lord.
Be with us, Lord, as we commit our lives to you.
Lord, pour your love into every pore of our being. Turn us again to you, O Lord, and awaken our spirits to your love and mercy. Come, let us worship and offer our voices of praise to God.
Let us open our hearts and spirits to God this day.
Amen. Let us now join in our celebration of praise and worship. Everybody, clap your hands. We praise you, O Lord. participation. Gracious God, we draw near this day to worship and hear the word you have prepared for us. Lord, be with us as we commit ourselves to being your disciples. Your word reminds us, I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Help us to face the future unafraid, trusting in your loving care and presence with us. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. We will now receive our liturgical dance ministry with guest soloist Paris McCracken with her praise dance to the music selection, Walk on Water.
I've never been stepping off the ship to a life that I've never seen, stepping out in faith, trying to see if I could swim. I know the billows are raging and the storms coming in, but walks on water. I know who walks on water. I know who walks on water. Stepping in.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Our first scripture reading this morning is found in the Old Testament. Please listen and follow along as I read Exodus chapter 20, verses 13 through 15. You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. Our gospel reading this morning is found in the New Testament. The Gospel of John, chapter 12, verses 27 through 33. Now my soul is troubled, and what should I say? Father, save me from this hour? No, it is for this reason that I have come in this hour. Father, glorify your name. Then a voice came from heaven. I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again. The crowd standing there heard it and said that it was thunder. Others said, an angel has spoken to him. Jesus answered, this voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself. He said this to indicate the kind of death he was to die. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Let us now receive the ministry of music by soloist Sandra Gray, Rise Up. After which, Reverend Ken Walden will continue his sermon series on the Ten Commandments with the message for today, Live and Let Live.
You're broken down and tired of living life on this merry-go-round, and you can't find the fighter, but I see it in you, so we gon' walk it out. Ooh, mountains, we gon' walk it out.
Afraid, I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand
and I'll rise up. I'll rise like the day. I'll rise up. I'll rise like the day. I'll rise up in spite of the ache. I'll rise up and I'll do it a thousand times again. And I'll rise up. I'll rise like the day. I'll rise up in spite of the ache. And we'll rise up high like the waves. We'll rise up in spite of the ache. We'll rise up and we'll do it a thousand times again. For you, for you, for you.
Amen. Many of you may remember these past several weeks we have been embarking on a sermon series. We've been doing that because during the season of Lent, we are continuously, persistently trying our best to follow our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ step by step in 2021. And we understand that during the season of Lent, Jesus fasted for 40 days and for 40 nights. We also understand that when Jesus was living, Jesus did not have the New Testament to read because it was currently taking place. The New Testament as we know it was not written and compiled as the way that we receive it until many years later. But Jesus was aware of the Old Testament, the Torah, and that is what he read. Our Old Testament. He was aware of Moses and the Ten Commandments. We know that because time and time and time again, Jesus would mention Moses, and also Jesus would talk about the Ten Commandments. So many of you know that a few weeks ago, the first part of the sermon series, because when we look at the first three commandments, we can summarize it in that theme. And that's put God first. The second part of the sermon series, we looked at the commandments 4 through 5, and we decided that that theme for the fourth and fifth commandment, do not forget. And now we come to the third series, and we will primarily look at the commandments 6 through 8. Which was read so brilliantly according to Exodus, the 20th chapter, 13 through 15. And our theme today is live and let live. For we find those commandments, you shall not murder, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not steal, live and let live. This theme on live and let live is not easy today because our nation has been shaken by a series of murders. Many of you know that in Atlanta, Georgia, we have just experienced as a nation some horrific murders committed against our Asian community. And may all of those people rest in peace. May all of the families experience God's comfort and God's care. And may all parties in this sad, tragic narrative, even the one who did the murdering, may he even experience new levels of God's revelatory power, which is needed. Live and let live. it seems as if time and time and time and time again we find on the pages of our newspapers and on the radio waves, senseless murders. People having their lives taken away. And at Holman United Methodist Church, we stand by our Asian brothers and sisters. We take pride that our bishop is of Asian descent. We take pride that our district superintendent is of Asian descent. And at Holman United Methodist Church, we've always had a history of loving all of God's people. Some of you know even our first permanent pastor in the person of Reverend Dr. L.L. White. In the 1960s, Holman United Methodist Church had a full-time associate pastor in the 1960s. And he served here with distinction and with pride. Holman United Methodist Church has had also full-time Caucasian associate pastors. And not too long ago, Holman United Methodist Church had another full-time associate pastor of Asian descent. So we believe in building bridges, not walls. And we believe that all people are worthy of love and dignity and respect. I am glad to announce that for the past few months, I've been in a lot of high-level meetings with the Japan General Counselor. And I'm happy that Holman United Methodist Church will be a part of the LA Japan initiative. And what that means is we will help a variety of people of color, particularly Black people and Asian people. We will work together in meaningful and insignificant ways. I am happy that we serve a God. We serve a God that loves us so much that God wants us to live. Let live. Jesus Christ informs us in the scriptures that Jesus came into this world so that we may have life, and life abundantly. Now, I have to tell you that there's a variety of forms of life. Yes, there is physical life that can be taken away, but that is not the only kind of life. There's also organizational life. There's relational life. There's religious life. There's dreams also have life. Not only can a person kill another person physically, but we also have the power and the influence to kill people's dreams. During this month of March, Women's History Month, Eleanor Roosevelt, one of our former first ladies, she said that the future belongs to the people who believe in the beauty of their dreams. My brothers and sisters, whatever dreams that you may have, hold on to them. Do not allow anyone to kill them. And my brothers and sisters, whatever dreams that you may be aware of, that someone else may possess, nurture them. Give them life. Give them oxygen. Do not try to stomp on people's dreams. Live and let live. I know that divorce is a fact. It's a reality of our lives. I understand that some people, some couples, they may grow together. And that is required by God's grace and God's mercy. And some couples, they may grow apart and get a divorce. And that is also needs God's grace and God's mercy. I know that we live in a world complicated. People are complex and the world is highly complicated. I know that it is easy for one person to say that you should not steal if he or she has a refrigerator full of food. But yet, it is much more difficult if a person has no food in their refrigerator. It is much more difficult for that person to pass by an item without taking it if they think that is their only choice of survival. That is why our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ supplies grace and mercy. But let me tell you, these rules and commandments, they are made to protect us. Ultimately, God does not want us to hurt ourselves. God does not want us to hurt one another. God wants us to live and live abundantly and let others live as well. Eleanor Roosevelt said, "The future belongs to the people that believe in the beauty of their dreams." And in March, a few days ago, there's a woman by the name of Rosalind Brewery. She just became the first Black CEO of Walgreens. A few days ago, as she became CEO of Walgreens, she became the first current and only woman. She became the only Black woman to be CEO of a Fortune 500 company. Some of you know that the first one was Ursula Burns a few years ago when she became CEO of Xerox. Now, Miss Ursula Burns, she's retired. Now we have Rosalind Brewery. She joins the ranks of three other Blacks who CEOs of Fortune 500 companies. Rosalind, she did not allow her dreams to die. Rosalind grew up in the city of Detroit. She went to Spelman College, and she shares a story how after her first 2 years of Spelman College, her parents told her that she would not be able to return to Spelman after her second year because her parents, they did not have a lot of money. And actually her parents, they were very transparent with her. They were falling on hard times. Rosalind shared that her mother never graduated from high school. Her father never graduated from high school, but still they nurtured her dreams. They wanted her to live and live abundantly. Rosalind shared those concerns with some of her administrators at Spelman College, some of her professors at Spelman College, and they listened to her. And rather than those administrators and those professors, rather than they telling her, "Hey, go home, do what you can, maybe this will be a dream deferred." No, they asked Rosalind to apply to scholarships. They asked Rosalind to take extra jobs. They nurtured her dreams. And rather than Rosalind leaving college for a couple years, she remained in college, received scholarships, and worked and worked and worked. And she was able to graduate with the people that she entered with. Rosalind, she has a career of living. Live and let others live. Most recently, she was the COO of Starbucks, and before that, she was the CEO of Sam's Club. But a few days ago, she became CEO of Walgreens, one of the Fortune 500 companies. God's blessings upon her journey. When you decide to live and let others live,
God will bless you. A few years ago, Rosalind, because she's a first-generation college graduate, and even in 2021, most black students today are still first-generation college students. A few years ago, Rosalind committed an impressive amount of money for first-year, first-generation college students to Spelman. I'm not going to talk about Rosalind too long, but I'm proud of her. She's a United Methodist. She attends, her family's connected to Impact United Methodist Church in Atlanta, Georgia. But when we decide to live and let others live, God works more miracles. When we decide to nurture people's dreams, when we decide rather than taking from people, we will nurture people, compliment people. There's an Asian proverb that says, friendship first, competition second. Friendship first, competition second. Friendship first is important because if we do not commit ourselves, our energies, and seeing people as colleagues, seeing people as human, seeing people as extensions of ourselves, we may be more inclined to kill, to hurt, to maim, to destroy. When we do not see people as friends first, we may be inclined to steal, to take, to destroy. When we do not see people as reflections of ourselves, friendship first, competition second, when we do not focus on friendships as brothers and as sisters, we may do things that will violate God, violate ourselves, and violate the community in which we exist. Live and let others live. In 2021, during this season of Lent, we understand that the enemy tried to convince Jesus to hurt himself, jump over a bridge, commit suicide. As we are listening to this and spending this time together, we know that suicide is increasingly a reality in our country and in the world. Why would the enemy want Jesus to jump over a bridge, a mountain? Because the enemy knew that Jesus had special things in store in his future. The enemy knew that Jesus would become the savior of the world. The enemy knew that he did not want Jesus to fulfill what God had in store for Jesus' destiny. The reason why the enemy is so preoccupied with you hurting yourself, with you making bad decisions, because the enemy knows how bright your future is. The enemy knows how much power you have within you. Do not allow the enemy to stop your life prematurely. God wants you to live and let others live. The enemy knows that you are brilliant, you are beautiful, you have God's angels circling all around you. For the future belongs to the ones who dare to believe in the beauty of their dreams. That is what Eleanor Roosevelt said. Rosalind Brewery just became CEO of Walgreens because she dared to dream. And others nurtured her along the way. My hope and prayer for all of you is that you will not allow anyone to kill your dreams. My hope and prayer for all of you is that not only that you will dare to dream, but you will also dare to help other people achieve their dreams as well. Live and let others live. Question: how are you nurturing life? In the name of the Father, and in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My brothers and sisters, we have responded to the word of God through the preached word, through prayer, through dancing, through song, through fellowship. And now it is time that we give unto God a portion of our tithes and offering. We could not go on at home in United Methodist Church without God's guidance and without your generosity. So we thank you for your prayerful support, and we also thank you for your financial support. At home in United Methodist Church, we are appreciative of the checks that you send and the ways in which you support us through our social media platforms by giving online. At home in United Methodist Church, we believe in living, in letting others live. That's why I invite you to not only give to Holman United Methodist Church, but consider giving an offering to our Holman CDC. Our Holman CDC is committed to living and letting other young people live. That's why our Holman CDC is dedicated to training young people, on-the-job training. We encourage you to give. Through our Holman CDC, we also minister and we help foster kids that do not have a permanent home. We encourage you to give. Through our home in CDC, we also have an initiative beyond the battlefield, where we have a commitment to women military veterans. At home in United Methodist Church, we believe in living and letting others live. That is why I encourage you to give to our home in permanent endowment, where your financial contribution can live on in perpetuity. And our permanent endowment focuses upon scholarships, among other initiatives. I am excited about seeing many of you on Palm Sunday in our drive-in service. We will have a drive-in service, and I encourage you to register through Eventbrite. Sandra, please share some other announcements.
Thank you. Okay. Our radio broadcast this ministry, Connected Heart to Heart. We give thanks for the opportunity to be in ministry with the greater community. Through the radio broadcast, ministry, and the generosity of our sponsors, together, we reach a broad audience in Los Angeles and beyond. And through your sponsorship, we can share your message and spread your good news. Our flowers on the altar in celebration of Women's History Month, and our upcoming special presentation of Women in the Bible by Rose Whitehead on March 28th via Zoom. We give thanks for the journey, courage, leadership, and example of Women of Holman, our community, the nation, and the world, Holman United Methodist Women. Appreciation messages. Pastor Ken Walden and the Holman United Methodist Church family, thank you for your prayers and thoughts. We appreciate your expressions of sympathy, Marvin and Earlene Powell and family. Pray for the bereaved. Holman member Jasmine Lyles, 23, daughter and granddaughter of Holman members Tamika Martin Lyles and Thomas Martin, respectively, passed away on March 12th. Homegoing services are pending at this time. Flora Arter, 92, Holman member, passed away on March 14th. Funeral arrangements are pending at this time. Prayer request, Mark Clay, Tamika Martin Lyles and family, Thomas Martin and family, family of Flora Arter, and all who stand in the need of prayer. The general announcements. I draw your attention to the worship bulletin that can be found on the Holman United Methodist Church website for details of the following announcements. Lenten Love Gift, $40 for 40 days of Lent. Palm Sunday drive-in service worship sign up. Please, we're having a drive-in service and you don't want to miss this, but the space is limited. The communion visitation teams are looking for volunteers to do communion visits to our sick and shut-in. Please call the church office. Also in the bulletin are the list of Holy Week virtual activities, information regarding the virtual Easter lilies that can be given to adorn our altar. There are also scholarship opportunities for high school students. Alpha Phi Alpha has a scholarship and the Allen Henry Memorial Scholarship. The Bell Tree of Life, that you can adorn our bell tree in loving memory or honor of someone. Also, the West District Leadership Training in the month of April. Please look at the bulletin for all of the details for these various announcements. Thank you.
Thank you. When we say live and let live, we mean Black Lives Matter. When we say live and let live, we mean Asian lives matter. When we say live and let live, we mean every life that comes unto question or scrutiny unjustifiably. So open your ears, open your eyes, open your hearts, and receive this blessing. May God's love, protection, and direction always be with you. May God's angels always surround you. And may God's Holy Spirit allow you to live and live abundantly all the days of your life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Bye.
that you have enjoyed our broadcast today and that it met a spiritual need in your life. If it was helpful, you can support this radio ministry by donating online at holmanchurch.com or by calling the church office at 323-703-5868. Again, that's 323-703-5868 or online at holmanchurch.com. That's H-O-L-M-A-N, holmanchurch.com. Holman Church is located at 3320 West Adams Boulevard. That's Adams Boulevard and 4th Avenue in the historic West Adams District of Los Angeles. We wish God's blessing on you to have a wonderful week, and thank you for sharing this time with the Holman United Methodist Church on radio station KJLH 102.3 FM. Remember, you can contribute and find out more about us at holmanchurch.com. We hope to hear from you and see you soon.